This is going to be a really quick repair video because last night when I was using my 25-ish amp battery charger / UPS thing, it decided to go bang and smoke a lot, and I'm not sure if it was going to keep on working after that because I yanked the power cord and battery leads ASAP, but I've narrowed the problem down to these filter caps here on the primary side. So there's a good chance it still works, but given the amount of smoke and noise it made, I'd rather replace them than keep going. And just a quick fix, I've dug up this old server power supply, which has two 1 microfarad X-rated caps there, which I'm going to use to replace these ancient 0.22 microfarads. They're pretty much the same size, so it should work out okay. Turns out this thing is really well designed, because to remove this board you just undo two entire screws, two or three really easy to disconnect connectors, and you've got it in your hands. And now we can really inspect the carnage in there. That cap's definitely a goner. There's no doubt that's where the smoke came from. And I've also got my new-ish, late 90s vintage caps, which are going to fit just perfectly. They are slightly wider than the originals, but as you can see, the board has holes for slightly wider caps for both of them as well, so this is probably not going to be a problem at all. Fantastic. And that's the monitor right there. This cap's seen better days, but it's probably been in quite heavy duty for about 25 years or so. So I don't blame it for giving in. Its friend isn't too far behind. You can see it's starting to crack up a bit, as these caps usually do. They are reefer brand though. They tend to make really, really good caps. Especially their electrolytics. We've got one of these white plastic can ones here. These tend to last forever. I've never seen one of those go bad. And they're very common around here. And here we have a bit of aftermath. It's strange how it seems as if it's been fluid being flung around out of this cap. Must be melted plastic or something like that, since it's a film cap, not an electrolytic. Well, time to get the new ones installed. Ah, it turns out that aging cap might not be the root cause of this issue, because, as it turns out, the solder joints on the main inputs are very clearly cracked. And there we go, everything's hooked back together, so let's see if it'll fire up without smoke this time. It should turn on as soon as you put the plug in. It should give us about 14.1 volts. Yep. And just to be sure, let's see if the inverter still works. It does. This thing still has, I noted, a couple of wide class capacitors in there which look a bit worn, but I don't have this thing mainly for the inverter, so I'm not going to bother with those right now. If they blow, they blow, and I'm probably going to find out. The good thing about wide-class capacitors though is they tend to fail non-dramatically, they tend to just go open. And that's a very good thing, since they are supposed to go between main serve and live, so you wouldn't want to have a cap short out and give your improperly air-fed device a live chassis. Anyway, that'll be it for this repair video. Cheerio.